That'll be incredible as we continue here from the Toyota Arena, a sellout in Ontario. For 77 days this past summer, Unholy Union had gold.
The following is a tag team match scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, Isla Dawn and Alba Meyer, Unholy Union!
Of course, Wade, then they had the trip to Bash in Berlin and came home empty-handed.
Yeah, this is a tag team duo that has really dominated the planet, including in various incarnations of NXT. However, domination in the tag ranks here in the women's division on Raw and on SmackDown, a far more difficult proposition to try and dominate in, even more so when you have the likes of Jade Cargill and Bianca Belair acting as the linchpins of that division.
Now, they did rebound, did Unholy Union. This will be another meeting with Damage Control to maintain lofty status. They had a victory over Damage Control on September 2nd.
Certainly more than capable of getting back to the very, very top, which is what they're looking to do now.
Eo. Now, hold up. I'm not here for that. I'm here to give credit where credit's due because you and I, we had one for the ages last week. Now, don't get me wrong, you call me slipping, but just let me know when you want to run it back because you best believe that's not happening again next time.
I look forward to it because next time, I'm not just coming for you. Next time, Damage Control are coming for those tag team titles.
Now, see, that is where you lose the plot. You might have caught my girl slipping, but understand, we always, always stand on business. So when you see us, best understand, you won't even touch our tag team titles.
But you know what? You know what? Since you want to bring up the tag team titles, I think you two need to be focused on Unholy Union, because last time I checked, they had y'all number last time y'all met in the ring.
Hello.
So please understand this. No matter who wins tonight, these titles, they're not going anywhere. But good luck tonight.
Bye.
Look at your thing.
Well, I'll tell you, Bianca mentioned it, and you listen to Busted Open or any of the industry podcasts this week, everybody was saying Io Sky, one of the best women's matches of the year last week, and earning it, conquering Bianca Belair.
And their opponents representing Damage Control.
But now it's back to tag action. You take that momentum from last week, you get the tag team back together, and you're circling around the championship opportunity with the two you just saw, Jade and Bianca.
Yes, indeed. And Joe, you can count Bianca Belair singles losses in WWE on one hand. That was a massive win for Io Sky last week. And as great as Io Sky is and has always been, it felt like a shocker. Here's the key part, though. You have to follow that up with victory here. It's so difficult to get momentum in this game when you have that massive momentum coming off that singles win against Belair. If you don't follow it up with victory here tonight, you will be kicking yourself for months.
I thought you nailed it with your analysis last week, Wade, of her technical advantages. When she, I mean, you saw it with the way she countered the KOD attempt and then the small package for the win. She is so wildly skilled.
Yeah, so well-versed. It really is difficult to outmaneuver somebody like a Bianca Belair and indeed Unholy Union, but if anyone can do it, it's Io Sky and Kairi Sane.
Alba Fire squaring off to open things up.
And don't forget, last week it was supposed to be Kairi Sane who was in competition in that matchup against Belair. She got switched at the last minute. She wasn't cleared, had an eye issue going back several weeks. It was caused by crashing into our announce desk. Is now cleared, however.
I mean, wait, that was brutal. Remember, the Intercontinental Championship match is coming your way tonight. Jey Uso has never had a singles championship against Bron Breakker, who has been one of the most dynamic, ascendant young stars in the game. That is coming your way. And for checking things out on X just moments ago, and Universal Champion, Undisputed Champion Cody Rhodes just simply put out a tweet of endorsement that said, yeet.
Jey Uso has gold on his mind, so do both of these two tag teams looking to earn themselves an opportunity potentially at the tag champs Belair and Cargill, and right now it is all about damage control.
Kairi Sane lining both of them up.
Kairi Sane, of course, a two-time women's tag champ here in WWE, albeit not with Io Sky, with Asuka.
Sane up top. Big right hand. Hooks the legs. And a kick out at two by Isla Dawn.
Unholy Union, not even close to getting out of the blocks thus far. You see that tape or that band-aid over the eye of Kairi Sane covering up some scarring or whatever from that crash into our announce desk, but she has looked superb from the off. Just a step ahead of Isla Dawn thus far.
Oh, big kick on the outside to fire. And she's matched up and then reaches for that eye that you detailed.
Needed something from Unholy Union. Kairi Sane is down. Oh! Divide and conquer approach. Right now, it is the Unholy Union on top. Can they score victory?